Well, if you haven't heard already, footage for Elden Ring has been leaked online, and in this video we're going to be discussing what we saw in that leaked footage, what it means for the game, and what are some of the mechanics you can expect based on that footage. However, we won't be showing the footage here for a couple of reasons. First, we highly respect Bandai Namco and From Software, and we feel it'd be doing them a disservice to show it, primarily because the footage is very, very old. It is not new footage of the game, so it isn't a perfect reflection of the things that you're going to see in Elden Ring. Additionally, the footage is very, very poor quality as it was taken off screen by someone's cell phone, and it's really hard to watch, so we sort of sifted through it for you, and in this video we're going to kind of go through the bullet points of things we've noticed. The first thing I want to start talking about here is stealth. You can see in the footage that there is a character creeping up behind an unaware enemy, sort of crouched, and then he does some sort of finisher on him, much like you would in Sekiro, for instance, and there's this like backstab animation that happens. This is something that I don't think too many people have talked about. I was not aware of for Elden Ring, but it seems like there's going to be a stealth mechanic not too dissimilar from Sekiro. I'm not sure how that affects backstab mechanics while in combat, because it does look like there are also backstabs as well. It's really hard to tell from the footage because it's not the best quality, but I don't know if that means you could only do backstabs out of combat or how that works, so that'd be something interesting to see moving forward. Another thing you can see present in the footage is a jump mechanic. This is something we've talked a little bit about. It's not a secret that jumping has been in this game, or is going to be in this game, and it's been in Souls games. But one thing that differentiates it, sort of, is that it seems like you can do a standing jump. That is to say, you can hop if you want, rather than having to run and get a jump. So that's going to be interesting to see how that makes it into the game. This is a mechanic that was also in Sekiro. You could jump straight up in the air. Seems you can do that in Elden Ring as well. I don't think it's going to have quite the, you know, elevation or versatility in Elden Ring combat, but time will tell. Another interesting tidbit is mounted combat. We knew mounts were going to be in the game. You're going to ride around. There was some speculation on exactly how mounted combat would work. You can see it clearly in the video that he is attacking from horseback, the character there, and he's also attacking another character or other characters on horseback. So he's not just fighting enemies on the ground, he's also engaging in other mounted characters. So this is going to be really interesting to see how much of a role this plays in Elden Ring, if this is just something that happens rarely or if it becomes a frequent occurrence. Another interesting thing that's been confirmed by this footage is that there are iframes on rolls. At one point you can see a character rolling through the fire of a dragon attack and not taking damage, so that's really, really interesting. I think people expected this. If you're going to play a game that is, you know, very, very similar to Souls but different, I don't think a rolling mechanic would be out of the question, but to see it in practice and know it's there and know it has iframes, I think is a, you know, very reassuring fact to players and, you know, fans of the Souls franchise. A couple other things that just jumped out at me, you know, initially after watching, and I watched it several times, but just that really grabbed me was that if you look at the weapons, they look very, very similar to Dark Souls. You see a broadsword that looks straight out of Dark Souls. You see a spear that looks the same. You have scimitars that look the same, but a little bit different. The shields look similar. You see the hand axe there that looks similar to the hand axe in Dark Souls. So it feels like a lot of those similarities, you know, in Dark Souls are going to be there. They have said that there are going to be more weapons than Dark Souls 3 for those of you out there who love the weapons of that game. I think you can expect a lot of the same ones you saw in Dark Souls 3, maybe just based on what we've seen, but probably then a lot more on top of that. So you might get your cake and get to eat it too. You might get all the things you love from Dark Souls 3 returning, maybe, and you might get new stuff on top of that. There were also a couple of magic spells shown in the video footage. One of them looks just like Homing Soul Mass. The guy summons like four floating blue balls above his head, just like Soul Mass or Homing Soul Arrow from Demon Souls. Looks very, very similar to that. And another one where he summons like a sword and does a sweep, but then also a thrust, reminds me a lot of Soul Greatsword from Dark Souls 3. So all indications, even though, again, keep in mind this is an old build of the game, this is not a new build, are that it's going to use a similar magic system to the Souls games, for better or worse. In my opinion, the magic systems of the Souls games were probably one of the weakest things, even though I love the magic. I always felt like the animations and things like that were not fantastical enough as maybe some other RPGs. And I'm hoping that this stuff's gotten a facelift since from this old footage. I have not seen anything myself. Obviously, we are waiting for the actual footage of the game that will be released by Bandai Namco and From Software whenever they decide. But if you look at it just based on this footage, you can see that it's very, very similar to Dark Souls. Another thing I noticed while looking through the footage is that there seems to be a boss fight or something where the character walks in and this guy comes out of the ground and they're about to fight. What looks particularly interesting to me is that the guy comes out of the ground like he's being summoned. If you're familiar with what the animations for being summoned look like or summoning a character in Dark Souls, particularly Dark Souls 3, it seems to have a very similar animation. So I don't know if it was you know, the character summoned it, or if it's, you know, but that animation being in the game really makes me think that summoning and the way summoning has been in previous Souls games is probably going to make it into Elden Ring. And it may work very, very similarly. And this is something we've theorized about in our videos that we published recently, that multiplayer might be very, very similar to Dark Souls. I think that's slightly confirmed that a little bit for me, just seeing that footage, but we don't know entirely for sure just yet. I think also another thing that really jumps out at you is once you look at the footage, you see that the art style of the game is just totally From Software to a T. It reminds you a lot of the Dark Souls franchise with the dark fantasy going on, and it looks to be either the same engine as Dark Souls 3 or possibly an upgraded version of that engine. I mean, it's hard to tell because the video quality is so poor, but graphically it looks very, very similar. So I think you could expect something similar to what you're seeing in Dark Souls 3. I don't know how the final product will look when it's polished up. I don't know if it'll look closer to the Demon's Souls remake in terms of graphic quality on next gen, or if it'll look more like the PS4 graphics of Dark Souls 3, or if it'll look somewhere in between. Keep in mind that this game has been announced for PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. This was announced a while ago. I don't think they've announced the game for next-gen consoles, though, and this could be a big reason for the radio silence. I mean, the console launch has come and gone last November, and Elden Ring maybe was supposed to launch before that, I don't know. But now that that console launch has happened, they probably have to develop a next-gen version of the game, and so they probably needed more time in order to do that, because they can't just put out, in my opinion, they can't just put out a PS4 and Xbox One version now, because I think that would be marketing suicide. I think the too long didn't read version of these notes in this video is essentially that the game will play a lot like the Souls franchise. I don't think people realized or expected it to be quite as much as it is. I think they, when they heard open world, mounted combat, maybe they thought something different, or they thought similar but different, kind of like the way Bloodborne is similar but different. But I feel like this game is a lot more similar to, you know, the Souls franchise than Bloodborne was, for instance, or Sekiro was. It's very, very similar to those games. I think that's the big takeaway here, for better or worse. I think there's people out there that this is, you know, music to their ears. This is exactly what they wanted. They wanted Dark Souls 4, but not Dark Souls 4. Maybe that's what they're going to get with Elden Ring. And for other people, I think, you know, maybe they wanted something, you know, a little more akin to Bloodborne, in the way that, you know, the mechanics were different enough that it felt like an entirely different game or entirely different franchise. But with Elden Ring, I feel like, in some ways, it might be the spiritual successor to Dark Souls. Much the way Dark Souls was to Demon's Souls. I mean, those are two games that share very similar mechanics, but are two entirely different games. And they're both beloved by the community. And in fact, a lot of people who have played Demon's Souls first, to this day, it's their favorite in the series, even though arguably, you know, Dark Souls, particularly by the time you get to Dark Souls 3, has more refined mechanics, more refined covenants, etc., more interesting bosses, etc. But it could be in that same vein. Elden Ring could be to Dark Souls what Dark Souls was to Demon's Souls. Regardless of what Elden Ring actually is, we're going to continue on with our theory videos about discussion about the mechanics of the game. I feel like so far we've been pretty close in terms of expectations with what we've thought of the game, what we've heard, with the conversations we've had and everything we've seen and read over time. I think we've been pretty spot on with what we're theorizing. Obviously, we're trying to create new ideas as well that may not make it into the game, but I think so far what I've seen of Elden Ring is about what I expected it to be. I always had this idea of what Elden Ring would be in my head, and I think what I've seen so far matches that almost to the letter. So make sure you guys check out those videos. We'll be publishing another one later this week and some more next week as well. And what do you guys think? I mean, is this the game that you expected Elden Ring to be? Does knowing that the video is old change your perception of it? Does it matter to you that it's old, or does it pretty much solidify for you exactly what Elden Ring is? Is it too similar to Dark Souls? Would you rather it was a bit different, or, you know, are you expecting it to change a bit before launch?